Resolume Avenue is leading the way in bridging the gap between visual and audio performance apps. Among the tools available for AV performances, you can find playback of video and audio files, automatic beat syncing, beat looping, VST plugins, and the ability to control both audio and video effects at the same time. Still, if you want more control over the audio side of your gig, you're more likely to use a dedicated audio app like Ableton Live or Traktor. This video will show you how to exchange MIDI information between those apps and Resolume Avenue, so you can have the best of both worlds. The first thing to do is to get communication going between the audio app and Avenue. There's different ways of going about this, depending on whether you have a one or two computer setup, and of course if you have a Mac or PC. For all the info on setting this up, it's best to follow the step-by-step tutorial on the Resolume website. Note that it's always recommended to run each app on a separate computer. The thing is that real-time video manipulation is hard enough on the poor computer as it is, and you don't want to push it over the edge by running a separate audio app at the same time. Once you've got everything up and running, it's very easy to start exchanging MIDI data. The most basic setup is to have both apps running on the same MIDI clock. Simply tell your audio app to send it and tell Avenue to receive it. Now both apps are running on the same time base, and all BPM related activities such as clip playback and property automation will run in time to the music. Taking things a step further, you can also trigger clips directly from your audio app. To set this up, create a new MIDI track in your audio app. Make sure both your app, as well as the track itself, are sending MIDI data to your communication device. Then pencil in a MIDI note, play the clip, and switch to Resolume. Here, make sure that Resolume is listening for the MIDI data, and then start MIDI detecting. Click on the clip that you want to sync to this MIDI note. Since your audio app is constantly sending this note, the clip will map automatically. Once you see your MIDI note appear, you can stop detecting. Switch back to your audio app, erase the previous note, and repeat the process with another note and another clip. In Resolume, you can set the clip trigger style to piano for note on-off functionality. This can be done on a global level or on a per clip basis. You can turn off beat snapping for all MIDI sync clips because the audio app will take care of the quantization. Note that you can use the same mapping technique to trigger a whole column of clips or virtually any other button style interface element. Once you have everything mapped and set up correctly, you can switch back to your audio app and pencil in your sequence. A very powerful feature of Ableton Live 8 is that you can group tracks together. So when you trigger a clip in Ableton, it triggers a clip or a sequence of clips in Resolume. It's also possible to sync slider parameters in Avenue to the effects in your audio app. With Ableton, this is a bit hacky, since you'll first need to assign a physical MIDI controller to control the effect in Live. This is not really much of an issue, because if you're a seasoned Live user, chances are you're using several MIDI controllers anyway. After setting up the MIDI control, you can now use the same technique as before to assign that effect control to a video effect in Avenue. Note that you don't need to use the hardware controller anymore, and just changing the parameter with the mouse will do. These were some of the basics of exchanging MIDI data between Resolume Avenue and other apps. Although I've used Ableton Live as an example here, the basic functionality can be found in most other audio performance apps. And this technique can actually be applied to any program that is capable of sending MIDI, be it audio, video, or otherwise. Fun syncing audio and video, and I hope that this video will help you push the limits of AV performances. This is Joris de Jong from Hybrid Visuals signing off. When Resolume Avenue was first released, the question on everybody's lips was whether there would still be support for interactive Flash files. With the 3.1 update, full ActionScript 2 and 3 enabled Flash is now supported in Resolume Avenue. This video will show experienced Flash heads some nifty new features, and if you didn't already know about the Flash support that Resolume offers, this video will open up a new world for you. Basically, Flash files behave like normal video clips in Resolume. You can import them from the file browser, or if you're on a Mac, you can use drag and drop from Finder. Once triggered, they behave like normal video clips, so you can scrub through the timeline, play backwards and forwards, pause it, randomize it, and adjust the speed for full epileptic style visuals. Of course, BPM sync playback is also possible. So far, nothing new. The same can be achieved with a rendered AVI or MOV file. The big advantage of working with Flash files is that you can change parameters on the fly. As opposed to working with pre-rendered movies, this way every performance becomes different and you can very easily adjust the style of the visual to the mood of the party. With the new ActionScript 3 support, any parameter can be published from Flash for live control within Resolume. In this file, for instance, the X and the Y scale can be controlled dynamically. Because Flash files are vector-based, there is no loss of quality when scaling up, and the edges stay smooth and crisp. Like any slider within Avenue, these parameters can be automated. for instance, to an audio input. Resolume now has support for sliders, text inputs, checkboxes, and buttons. In this file, rotation can also be controlled. When automated, notice that even at very slow speeds, the animation stays smooth, as opposed to frame-based video. A big thing is, of course, dynamic text support. Files with published text inputs can be changed on the fly. You can enter multiple lines of text and have full control over how these are displayed. This way you can build endless different text effects yourself in Flash or download some from the many online resources. Again, you have full control over the way the text animates. Another advantage is alpha support. Animations created on a transparent background can be composited directly on top of other animations, without a need for blending modes. Flash supports lots of interactive features, such as accessing information from the internet, RSS feeds, Flickr pictures, etc., etc., etc. Unfortunately, it goes beyond the scope of this video to go into detail on how to program your own interactive Flash files. For more information on this, the best starting point is the Flash chapter in the Avenue manual. Also, you can have a look at the examples that can be found in the Flash folder of the media that ship with Resolume. Of course, the internet has lots of information as well. A great online resource for free Flash files that can be used in Resolume directly is triggermotion.com, where some of the examples used in this video can also be found. That's it for now. I hope you enjoyed this brief introduction of Flash within Resolume Avenue. Until next time, this is yours, the Young from Hybrid Visuals, signing off.